In this video, I have brought you the question and answers from the poem A Day by Emily Dickinson. Hi, I'm Sanjeev, and you all are welcome to my channel. I have already uploaded a video on this very poem with the summary and analysis. You can check the link above and click that link and watch the video in my channel. Now, let's see the question answers. How does the poet describe the morning sun in the first stanza? So when you answer this question, make sure that you are explaining the first stanza. The speaker describes the morning sun with a confident tone, comparing it with the ribbons. According to the speaker, it is the steeples that receives the sun rays first, and the news of the sunrise spreads in the world too quickly, like a squirrel's run. What does the line, the news like squirrel rain mean? Question number two. This is the line which appears in the final line of the first stanza. The last line of the first stanza, the news like squirrel's rain, compares the news of the sunrise with a squirrel's run using a simile. This comparison implies that the news of the sunrise travels in the world too quickly, like a squirrel's run. Question number three. What do you understand by the line, the hills untied their bonnets? Answer. The line, the hills untied their bonnets, which is an example of personification, implies that after the sunrise, the hills covered with darkness previously become visible once the sun rays fall on their top. When a person removes the bonnets, his or her head becomes visible. Similarly, the hills seem to be removing their bonnets of darkness after the sunrise. Question number four. Is the speaker watching the morning sun? Why or why not? So answer it in the form of yes, no, and also justify your reason with the textual evidences. Answer. No, the speaker is not watching the morning sun. In fact, the speaker has already watched the sunrise and he is meditating on his observation, as evident by the use of past tense in the poem. Question number five. How does the sun set? So let's see what the speaker has to say. Make sure that when you write answer to this question, your answer is based on what the speaker says. The speaker has no clear idea how the sun sets because the speaker exactly does not know what lies after death. Question number six. What, according to the speaker, is a day? Answer. According to the speaker, a day is a unit of time between the sunrise and the sunset. In the poem, day has both denotative and connotative meanings, that is, dictionary meaning and contextual meaning. In terms of its denotative meaning, a day is a unit of time between, but in the connotative label, day refers to life itself, as sunrise and sunsets are the symbols used in the poem to refer to birth and death respectively. Question number seven. What purpose does the hyphen in the first line serve in the poem? You can see the hyphen just after the first line of the poem. I will tell you how the sun rose, comma, and there is hyphen. So what is the function of this hyphen in the poem? Answer. Emily Dickinson has used the hyphen in the first line of the poem to show the activities that follow during and aftermath of the sunrise. During the sunrise, the sun rays look like ribbons in the sky. Similarly, the rays fall on the steeples first and travel in the world too quickly like a squirrel's run. Question number 8. Who are the target audience of the speaker and why? So, who are the target audience of the speaker? Is it child or is it adult? And again, you have to justify your reason with the textual evidence. The target audience of the speaker are both children and adults. As this poem carries the perspective of a child speaker, even children can understand this poem as the description of a day. Children can identify themselves with the speaker. At the same time, this poem is meant for adults. Adults are capable of perceiving what lies beyond the surface meaning. They can understand the intended meaning of the poem. This poem is not just a description of a day, but also a description of life itself, with the rich symbols of sunrise and sunset standing for birth and death respectively. Now, question number 9. What makes this poem lyrical and sonorous? Discuss. When you answer to this very question, at first you describe what is a lyrical poem and how does the definition of lyrical poem fit in the context of this poem, and also explain what is the meaning of sonorous, and thereafter you have to say, is this poem sonorous or not? So the answer is, a lyrical poem is short, highly musical verse that conveys powerful feelings. The poet may use rhyme, meter, or other literary devices to create a song-like quality. Unlike narrative poetry, which chronicles events, lyric poetry does not have to tell a story. A lyrical poem is a private expression of emotion by a single speaker. In this definition of a lyrical poem, Dickinson's poem fits, as this poem, written in quatrain form, conveys the personal feelings of a single speaker towards the sunrise and the sunset. On the other hand, sonorous is something capable of producing a deep or ringing sound. In the poem, it is the quatrain form and the rhyme scheme pattern that contribute to the sonorous quality of the poem. Except the first stanza, the second line rhymes with the fourth line in the second, third, and the fourth stanzas, and this very repeated pattern, that is EFGF, HIZI, and KLML in second, third, and fourth stanzas, contributes to the melody and musicality in the poem. This brings us to the end of the question answers from the poem A Day by Emily Dickinson. I hope you enjoyed watching it. Thanks for watching.